Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today we're going to create a karaoke text effect. Okay, so this is a pretty easy effect to create. There's a lot of different ways you could do it, but I was thinking, you know, what's the easiest, what's the most efficient way of doing this? So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to change my workspace. I'm going to go over to Window, Workspaces, and I just want to choose the Captions and Graphics workspace. And I'll go over to the Edit tab. And of course, the first thing we need to do is we need to create some lyrics. So I'm just going to click this little new layer button and choose text. And I've got some lyrics down here that I'm just going to copy. And then I'll paste into this text box. And I won't spend too long sort of getting these looking right, but let's just come up with a nice bold sort of font. And we'll just work with that, I think, like that. Okay. So what we want with this text is, as the lyrics are being sung, we want this to gradually turn yellow for each word that's being sung. And the way that we're going to do this is by creating two different boxes or two different shapes. And the shapes represent when a line has been sung and also when an individual word has been sung. So what I'm going to do is go over to my essential graphics and I'm going to add a new rectangle. And I'm going to make this rectangle yellow. And I'm also going to make it so that it fills the frame. So I'm going to set this to 1920 by 1080, which is the frame size of my sequence. And the last thing that I want is I want this anchor point here in the shape to actually be on the far left side. So I'm going to drag this over to the edge. Now, I don't have snapping turned on at the moment. And just to be accurate, I want this to snap. So I'm going to go over to my View menu and choose Snap in Program Monitor. And then when I drag this over to the left here, it should snap into place like that. And I'm going to call this Lines Sung. And then the next thing I want to create is another box that looks exactly like this, but it's called Word Sung. But first what I'll do is I'll move this box up. So I'm going to drag this up so that it's just covering up the first line of lyrics. And then I will right click this and I'm going to choose duplicate and I'll change this to words sung. And what I'm going to do is move the words sung down so that they cover the next line like that. And I also want to be controlling the position of lines sung, the lines sung box, by the position of the words sung box. So what I'm going to do is something called pinning. So I'm going to go down to lines sung and I want to pin this not to the video frame, but I'm going to pin it to words sung. And the edges that I want to pin are the left and the bottom. And all that basically means is wherever I move this box here, that other box is going to move with it. Now with words sung, I actually need to adjust the scale of this, the horizontal scale of this. So I'm going to go down to this little lock here and unlock the scale lock. So now when I adjust the scale of the horizontal side of this, you can see I can actually move across the word. I'm just going to line this up so that it's the start of the line. And then I'm going to move my word sung box so that it's at the position of the first word in the song. So I'm just going to drag this up so that I'm ready to animate that on when the lyric comes on. And now what I want to do is I want to start to add some keyframes for this. And rather than keyframing the words as I go, I'm actually going to keyframe all of the lines first. So if you've got the music there, you want to see when a particular line is sung, and then we want to add a keyframe for that. So I'm going to go over to my effect controls panel, and there's my words sung shape there. I'm going to twirl this open. I'm going to close up the appearance options. I just want to go down and focus on these transform options. And I'm going to add a keyframe for position, and I'm going to add a keyframe for horizontal scale. And then let's say we want to move forward to where the next line starts to be sung. And then I'm going to move this down vertically. And I'm going to add a keyframe for the horizontal scale. I'm not going to adjust the horizontal scale. I'm just going to add a keyframe for that. And then I'll want to do that for each individual line. I move this down and then I add a keyframe for the horizontal scale. I'll just do it one more time, move it down, and add a keyframe for the horizontal scale. And now I'm pretty much ready to start to animate each individual word. What we have right now is we just have this box sort of gradually moving down like this, but I don't actually want it to move down gradually. I want it to sort of skip to each line as each line starts to get sung. So to do that, I'm actually going to click the word position here. I'm going to right click my keyframes, and here where it says temporal interpolation, I'm going to click hold. And that means that rather than gradually adjusting between these two keyframes, it's just going to jump to the next keyframe so that it looks like this. So that it's just quickly jumping down as the keyframe changes rather than gradually changing between them. So that's good. And now I'm pretty much in a good position to start animating that horizontal scale. So what I can do is move my playhead across to the point where that first line has finished singing. And now I can adjust the horizontal scale across until that line is finished singing. Now, what I want to do now is hold that word until I get to the next line. So I'm going to turn that keyframe into a hold keyframe as well. And then I'll do the same thing with the next line. So I'll move my playhead to here. Let's say that the line has finished singing here. I'll drag this across and I'll turn this into a hold keyframe. And I'll do the same thing here, move this across and I'll set this to a hold keyframe until I get to the very last line where I can just animate that across as well and set that to a hold keyframe too. And so now I have something that looks like this. And I might just speed this up so you don't have to watch the whole thing in real time. But there you go. We have animated the actual time at which each line is sung and each word is sung. Of course, what we wanted to do is have the text turn yellow as it's being sung. And that's a very easy thing to do. It's probably the easiest thing of this whole process now, is all I have to do is move my text layer up to the very top, and I want to go down to the bottom here and just choose mask with text. So now that text is turning yellow as it's being sung. Now, usually what you want to have is you want to have a different color text underneath that indicates that the line hasn't been sung yet. And that's an easy thing to do as well. All we need to do is just add another rectangle. And I want a rectangle that's going to fill my frame. So 1920 by 1080. And I'm going to set this to white. And I just want to make sure that this shape is at the very bottom of all of this. And so now we very quickly animated the appearance of this text. You can see it's turning yellow as each line is being sung like that. And probably the only other thing that I would add to something like this, especially if you're putting it on top of a background, is just a drop shadow to make the text stand out a bit better. So I'll just grab a drop shadow. And you want to drag this to the very top of the layer stack in your essential graphics. And I'll turn the opacity up and I'll turn the softness up a bit as well so that the text stands out well now. But that's it. Very quickly, you've now just created your own karaoke text effect. Hey, I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, please like and subscribe and maybe check out some of these other videos that I made.